So married folks here tonight, round of applause. Some of our married couples, make some noise. Give yourselves a round of applause. Congratulations, yes. I got to send a shout out to my parents. My parents just celebrated their 57th wedding anniversary. 57 years, yeah. I asked my dad his secret to a long marriage. He goes, hearing loss. Well, my parents, because they're in their 80s now, they're obsessed with their health. I had to change the voicemail on their answering machine. Now you call their house, it's like, hi, reach the Yaffees. We can't come to the phone right now, because we're on the phone with a doctor. On the way to a doctor. Or at a doctor. If this is a doctor, please press 1. HMO, press 2. Medical lab with test results, press 3. If this is at pharmacist from Walgreens, please hang up. We found cheaper prescriptions in Canada. I'm sorry, but it's out of control with seniors and medication. It is nuts. My mom takes 5 pills just to remember to take her other 10 pills. She has enough medication to stock 3 Charlie Sheen sleepovers and a Lindsay Lohan relapse party. And the irony behind this thing, the people that told us we were teenagers don't do drugs or have sex. Now, thanks to prescription Medicare and Viagra, all they do is do drugs and have sex. We can't even pop in on grandma and grandpa anymore. Now we gotta give them 4 hours notice. Yeah, dad, can we come over today? No, what is it, arthritis stiff or Cialis stiff? Is it boner or bone spur? I need to know. My dad is still driving, 86 years old, still driving, mostly in a marked lane of traffic. He had an accident earlier this year in Palm Springs, California. He hit a patch of ice in Palm Springs, California. I'm like, Dad, how did you do that? Run over a drunk guy holding a daiquiri? I can't believe he hasn't crashed earlier. He sees perfectly well, but he can't see anything because he has eyebrows like a woolly mammoth. Have you seen these guys in the 80s with the lobster brows going on there? Looked like 2 Brillo pads came out of his forehead. Mom, don't kiss him. You'll put an eye out. His ears aren't any better either. Looks like he's trying to grow chia pets out of the side of his head. My mom shared this little gem with me the other day. She goes, oh, you were such a good baby growing up. We would go to the beach and the park and on picnics. We would leave you in the car. You wouldn't stir for hours. Thanks, Mom. That's called heat stroke. If you grew up in the 1900s, parents could do whatever they want to, right? They used to smack us with our own toys. Who got hit by your own toys growing up? Round of applause. Smacked by your own toys. I know you're out there. It's crazy. We cannot do that to our kids. Number 1, CPS. Number 2, we are not wasting a perfectly good $300 Xbox. When I was a kid, we had no Xbox. We had cardboard box. If you're lucky, you had sandbox. There was no we, it was just us. There was no ADD either, because we had to play in the street. That'll make you pay attention. I could not wait for the streetlights to come on. I was like the worst live Frogger game ever. They would hit us, neighbors would hit us, teachers would hit us. I think the postman took a few swings at me in my day. Toys that would kill and maim if you lived in the 1900s, right? Who remembers? We had these things called click-clacks. 2 glass balls on a string. What could go wrong there? Our toys were lawn darts, slip and slides, BB guns, slingshots, firecrackers. Everybody knew at least one kid with missing fingers or a glass eye. You always would see kids injured in the 1900s. Always. Skin knees, cast, black eyes, stitches. The last time I saw an injured kid, he had that little ace bandage wrapper on his wrist. What happened, dude? He goes, carpal tunnel, Call of Duty 3. It's different times, though. You know, I got a buddy. He doesn't even let his kids see. They don't even go outside. He bought him a Wii. He spent $250 for a Wii so they can stand in front of their TV set and pretend they're bowling. Last time I checked, for $250, you can go real bowling like 5,000 times. I cannot believe more minorities aren't into bowling. And think about that. That is the only sport you get points for knocking over 10 white rednecks.